This is my first mono-cooled camera by SVBONY. I've been lucky enough to get my hands on it, and in this video I'll tell you my thoughts about what I think of this. I'll highlight both the positives and negatives and perhaps help you make a decision if you are thinking whether to buy this or not. As always, let's first talk about its specs. This SV605MC is SVBONY's first deep sky mono astronomy camera. For those of you who don't know what mono is, well, it just means that this wouldn't spit out RGB images. Instead, it will give you black and white images. As you probably know, mono cameras are more sensitive and ultimately can be better choice for astrophotography. Most important thing about any camera, cooled or not, is its sensor. That's the heart of the camera. Well, this camera uses the well-reputed IMX533 sensor. This is the same sensor that you will find in ZWO-ASI 533mm Pro. It's a super sensitive and well-rounded sensor. You can expect 3.76 pixel size, which is pretty good. The resolution for this camera is 3008x3008, which is also awesome. Interestingly, this sensor is 1-inch diagonal format, so you can expect good Instagram size images. As I've mentioned somewhere else, another thing to look for when buying a dedicated astronomy camera is quantum efficiency. Well, this camera produces a very high QE value, which peaks at about 91%, which is amazing. For comparison, your ordinary DSLR has a QE, quantum efficiency, of about 30 to 40. So this is an effective, efficient camera. This sensor has the full well of 50,000E, so you can be confident that even the bright stars won't muddle up, even under long exposures, and you can expect better signal to noise ratio. This sensor is supported by USB 3.0, which makes sure that your data travels fast. This is a cooled camera, so it is equipped with cooling system. I've had the opportunity to test it out extensively, and I can report that the cooler works very well. I usually use this at minus 5 degrees Celsius, which helps me drown out the noise. In terms of temperature, you can push it max to about 30 degrees below ambient temperature, which is rare for me because I live in a cooler region. With minus 3 degrees, I only use about 30% of the power. And I have absolutely no complaints with the cooling mechanism. It works as it should. It doesn't take long to cool the camera down as well. By the way, to power the cooling system, you will have to plug in the power supply which is provided with the camera, not like ZWO, who don't supply power adapters for some reason. But what about the amp glow? Well, I'm happy to report that I have not yet seen any amp glow with this camera. The other SVBONY camera has amp glow issues. I'm talking about SV405CC. OSC camera, but this camera has absolutely no amp glow, absolutely zero. Let me show you a dark frame. As you can see, it has no amp glow. It does, however, have some other defects. It does, for example, show banding issues. But this can be easily resolved by taking darks and biases. I didn't notice any banding problems with my individual light frames. Let me show you some of the single light frames taken with this camera. So there is a lot going for this camera. It's very sensitive, packed with awesome features. It cools well and produces very nice, sharp looking images. And I think I can say with confidence that I recommend this if you are in the market for a new mono-cooled camera. So well done, SVBONY. Friends, let me know what you think of this. If you have any questions, please feel free to write in the comments below and I will make it a priority to get back to you.